from there on. All right, what's up, guys? So it's been a minute. I made a video. This is gonna be, you know, I'm back on the couch where I started my earlier videos. I figured that was a fitting place to kind of just restart. So I'm gonna do the channel a little differently because I'm still gonna have lots of toy reviews. We got some Legos. We got some toys. We got some My Little Ponies. We got some Voltron. We got some Power Rangers. We got some Japanese stuff. We got all kinds of stuff we're gonna review. I got a Fitbit Blaze we will do for you guys. Some video games. We got a lot on the plate, a lot of going on. But from my Facebook page, the biggest thing that everyone has been asking me about is this ketogenic diet that I started. So to break it down, first of all, I just want to say I'm not a doctor. I'm just somebody that looked this up. We had, initially, I wasn't looking this up to lose weight. I was looking this up for someone else. We had a friend die very young to diabetes. And because of that, we were looking at ways to help diabetes, whether that be diet, exercise, combo of the two, whatever. And we came across a TED Talk where a lady was speaking about the high-fat, low-carb diet. And we watched the video. It was interesting. We then continued to use terms that we learned from that video, such as high-fat, low-carb, ketosis, ketogenic. And we did more research. We found many more awesome YouTubers with great information. And I guess basically what this video is going to be, I'll give you what little bit of info I can, but basically what this is just a, I guess, an idiot's guide to what is keto and to help you make up your mind to whether you want to do the research and find out all. Because there's really so much that you can do, and there's so many different things. And when you get into it, there's even little subsects of some people think this is keto, some people think this is keto, and then... But let's just jump right into the meat of it. So, basically, what the keto diet is, why it works, and what the diabetes connection is when you eat things, they have carbohydrates. Those carbohydrates then go into your body and get turned into sugar. And your body uses this precious, delicious sugar for your energy, for your get up and go, for your everyday whatever you do. So that's pretty standard. So what we're going to do, in the one way that I've heard this explained, is our bodies are like a hybrid car. So it's been running off gas for all this time, but we're going to switch it over to electricity. So what you do is you then change your what they call macros, which is what you would put into MyFitnessPal. And MyFitnessPal is something I would recommend for you to do when you first get started with this. And you eat, you basically have to eliminate carbs almost completely, not completely. I mean, you're still going to have some carbs. You still need to eat some vegetables, and there are carbs in vegetables. And from my experience, that's where most of your carbs are going to come from if you're doing it the way I'm doing it. I probably lost 20, 25 pounds in a couple of months. I lost probably 10, 15 pounds in the first 2 weeks. I feel great. I don't get out of breath. I do karate, and I don't get out of breath as I used to. I don't get out of breath when I go upstairs. I don't get out of breath when I do exercise for a while. I mean, I really got to push myself to get out of breath. And I know my limitations and things. I've been a lot more healthy. I've lost a couple of inches around my waist, easy. Other people are doing it with me. They're having weight loss as well. I know someone that their sugar was right at 300 and something. They were taking metformin, and then now they're not. Their sugar's within the 130 to 160, maybe even sometimes like 113 or lower. Sorry about that. It's sickness time. But the sugar has got normal. And they quit taking their metformin, which I don't recommend you do unless you talk to your doctor, of course. But they did it to where they're like, okay, I'm not going to take it today, and we'll see how we feel. They were good, so I tried a few days. They always had it on them just in case, but it just the sugar maintained itself on this diet, and they didn't take the medicine. They felt there was no need, and they're going to follow up with a doctor. They just need the they're going to document their sugar and all that stuff, and then talk to the doctor. Maybe they'll get off the medicine. I'll get you guys updated if that happens. So, anyways, keto. You know the benefits: weight loss, more energy. Some say better libido. Some say that there's research to where, and I'm not going to go into a lot of the lady bit stuff because I'm not a lady. But again, if you do the research, there's been ladies that have used it to get pregnant, to get their period back, just for better health, better hormones, better health all around. But there's additional benefits for some of the ladies if you guys want to do that research. And there are several channels to where there are ladies that will talk to you about those benefits and what they do, and they'll go into the details because, you know, some of them have experienced it and went through it themselves. Some of them are doctors, and they'll tell you. Again, I'm not a doctor. I'm just telling you what I've researched, what I've done, and the results that I've seen. So I've been losing weight. I feel better. People have told me my hair was darker. I don't know. I shaved it all off, so you can't tell now. So how do you get started on keto? Well, what we did, a lot of things that you can have on keto are meat, eggs, fish, butter all day, like Paula Deen Express butter. Coconut oil is good. Avocados, broccoli, celery. I would say basically any meat. I'll give you an example I'll get up. My big thing I had to do was give up soda because I love Pepsi. But it's got lots and lots of sugar. Now, if you're like me and you're transitioning, if you can just quit it and go straight to water, it's beyond fantastic. You'll lose weight just from that. Like if you've been, you know, drinking sugary drinks and you're going to go to just water, that water is great for you. If you need a little transition, diet soda, if you look at the macros, I wish I had something nearby where I could show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to go get something in a minute and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So the little nutrition facts on the back. Diet soda has sodium, which you need on the keto, and I'll explain that in a second, and doesn't have the sugar. Now, it does have ingredients that people will say slows the keto process, and the diehard ketoers will tell you, stay away from it completely. And I think that's a good long-term goal. However, if you want to avoid the caffeine crash, and you've tried the water and you're just fiending for it, diet soda doesn't taste as good as regular soda, but it'll get you halfway there. So that aftertaste will kind of get you out of it, or you'll stay with it. It's a good pick-me-up when you need some sodium during that keto flu, and we'll get to the keto flu here in a minute, too. I know I've got too many facts all going at once here. There's a lot to cover, and I'm just going to give you the very basics. So a basic meal for me was I would get up and I would cook a couple of sausage. When you get sausage, make sure that you look at the macros, the little nutrition facts, and make sure there's no sugar in there. Because sometimes with sausage, especially bacon, and bacon you can have all day, especially bacon, they put stuff in there like sugar, maple, all this stuff. You have to look and make sure you get the uncured bacon. So I'll have bacon and sausage. I don't really like eggs, but a lot of people have eggs. They'll put ham in, they can put ham in there. They do have sandwich meat that if you look at these macros, your macros, what you're looking for, no carbs and some fat. If it has one carb, but it has a little bit of fiber, that cancels out sort of. So that's something to consider. There are things that are considered keto friendly because they're low carb, high fat. There's a lot of protein bars that are like that. But you got to take those. There is chocolate. There are things called fat bombs you can make. And she makes this fat bomb that tastes just like chocolate you'd buy at the store. But it's a fat bomb and it's no sugar. time fat. It's good stuff. And fat bombs, basically what you're going to find is you're going to have to come up with fat. Even if you eat mostly meat and eggs and all that stuff, you're going to have a lot of protein, and your fat needs to be higher than your protein. Again, there's more science to that. There's a little more refining to that once you get into the thing. But again, I'm just giving you the basics. Is this for me? Can I get this started? Is this worth researching to find more? Because I say that with anything, you always want to do your own research and find more and give it a little bit of a shot to try it out for you. Because it's great for me. It might not be good for you, but I hope that it is because it's been great for me. So we had the sausage and eggs. She has eggs, and then sausage and bacon. And then for lunch, sometimes I skip lunch still. Some people fast. There's kind of a controversy if you're bigger, if you can fast until like after 2 or 3 o'clock, that helps with the not having so much loose skin. Can't verify or deny. That's just information that's out there. So lunch, sometimes I'll make a pork chop. I just fry it up. They have low sugar ketchup. I use that. Just eat it with that. Let's see. Supper. Sometimes we'll make a meatloaf. Sometimes I'll do minute steaks, hamburgers without the bun. Sometimes we'll just have sausage and eggs and bacon. Sometimes I'll get chicken breast, put bacon around them. Sometimes we just have chicken breast. Sometimes we'll have taco salad. I'll get some frozen broccoli, and we'll put cheese on it. You can have cheese. You can't have milk, but you can have cheese, heavy whipping cream, sour cream. Maybe I can put some links. If this video gets some views, I'll put some links down. There's Facebook groups you can join. There's a big network out there, and there's lots of people that's been very successful for. There's options you can go when you eat out. You can go to just about any burger place if you want. Just don't get the bun. Most of them will substitute the fries for a salad. You can't have fries. Potatoes are super carbs. That's your big thing. When you're going to the grocery store, you're looking for, I don't know if this is a smart water. I don't know if you guys can see that. Probably not. But this is what I'm talking about, the nutrition facts. It'll say total carbohydrates or whatever. I wish I had something nearby that I could grab that had better than that. But you see what I'm talking about. You'll start noticing a pattern when you go to that bacon, when you go to the meat. No carbs, high fat. And when you get the hamburger meat, you want to get the higher fat. The low fat stuff is good, and it's for people that are eating carbs, because the carbs turns into sugar. And when you're using sugar for your fuel, then that fat just is that. It's fat. It goes to the fat, and it'll burn the fat if you get through all the carbs. But when you start counting your carbs that you're eating, oh my God, fries, bread, pizza, there's just so much carbs in all the bread and all the potatoes and all the starch and all the sugar. Apologize for that again. But you never get through the carbs, especially if you're drinking soda and stuff with, like, I think there's like 200 to 300 and something sugar and carbs per like cup, I think, basically. So, and that's, I'm not exact on that, but there's lots and lots of sugar in sugary drinks. So when you add the addition of this, and even when you're on that, even the protein can become sugar once it's run out of stuff. So you're going to burn through the protein if you're not limiting your carbs. There's different breakdowns. Some people say you want 75% fat. You want like 15 or 20% protein and then like 5, 10, 15% carbs a day. Most of your carbs will come from vegetables. Cheat days. So I wouldn't recommend cheat days for a while. Some people say never do a cheat day. Some people say it's okay to do a cheat day. The thing that I saw was basically, if you're going to any kind of workout, maybe have a little extra carbs. Not much. You definitely, if this is going to work, if you're going to go into what's called ketosis, which is where you're burning fat as energy instead of the carbs, that's where your weight loss is going to come in. That's where you're going to start feeling great. It's where you're not going to poop as much, so you might want to take a fiber supplement. You might need to take a magnesium supplement. And you might want to take one a day. And then that's when you're going to get all your good things. The ketosis is what makes this diet work. You're burning fat instead of sugar and carbs. So if you're not giving your body fat and drowning it in fat and starving it from carbs, then it's just going to choose the carbs and use that, and then you're just going to have all this extra fat. But that's where you got to use butter to cook stuff. Use the coconut oil to cook stuff. Use the fat bombs if you need. They've got bulletproof coffee that you can do. All kinds of different little techniques that you can do to custom tailor to your own life that fits into your work schedule and what you need to do in order to get that fat up there. MyFitnessPal, again, some people use it, some people don't. But if you're starting out, I highly recommend it. Another thing I highly recommend when you first start out, just use the basic building blocks. Chicken, beef, fish if you like it, pork, and just kind of experiment. There are free books you can get for Kindle. They're like YouTube channels where they give you recipes. They get the macros. Macros is something that's one of those terms you need to get used to. That basically means those nutrition facts on the back. And you can go into MyFitnessPal and you can scan the barcode. You can put the stuff in and it stays in there. And then you can figure out what you're going to have, and it goes in there and it'll put it in percentage for you. And that makes it visually easy for a lot of people to see, and a lot of people use that. So for supper, a typical dish that I have done is just get some chicken breast, cut them up, fry them up on a pan, cook that with just some spices, and I'll get some broccoli. Put the butter down so it simmers in the butter. Put it down, cover it in cheese, let the cheese cook in, and that's a vegetable. I just drink water, unsweet tea, which is... I did have Diet Coke for a little while, but mostly now it's just water. If I can drink cold water, we get this product placement, Kroger time, purified drinking water. If that's cold, man, I can drink that all day. And if I work out, I actually crave water above anything else after a workout. So the more water you can drink with this, the better. And I have heard that people that drink water, like if you're drinking at least 16 ounces, 500 milliliters, 1.05 pint. If you're drinking this at least that much per meal, and at least one of those in between meals, just drink as much water as you can. That, you know, the results have been better for those that drink water. So again, I'm not a doctor. I'm not telling you this is going to cure your diabetes. I'm telling you that I have seen that it has cured people's diabetes. I'm not telling you that this is going to be your miracle thing, but I'm telling you that it has been some people's miracle thing. And it could be your miracle thing. And I sincerely believe it's worth your time to give research, to look it up. Give it a try. If you guys like this, I'll start a weekly thing to where I'll say, okay, here's the menu. Here's what I did. Here's what I cooked. And I'll do a weekly weigh-in. If you guys want to see that, I'll do a weekly weigh-in. I'll say, okay, Monday. Well, I'll do a video on Monday. I'll do a video on Friday. Monday, here's what I weigh. Here's what I've ate every day, and then Friday we'll see what happens. If you guys want to do that to see some concisive proof, this is a new venture for me. I normally do toy reviews. So if you guys like this, give me a like, give me a comment. Share it around to your friends, people curious about keto. I will, if you guys are interested in this, I'll do more structured videos. I'll do some research. I'll leave you links. I'll give you the nitty gritty of, I'll watch 4-hour chats and I'll give you the basics of it, and then I'll link it and I'll put times to where you can go find what I'm talking about if you guys would be interested in that. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much to all the people on YouTube that have been such inspirations to me, that gave us the information to get this started. I'm going to do a video. Like I said, if this one does good, I'll do a video. I'll name all you guys, and I'll be sending you guys the messages. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope keto works for you. I hope this gave you a little clarity. You can ask me questions. I'll try to answer them, or I can point you to someone that can. And you guys have a good one. We'll bam it out, get the bird out, and you guys have a good one. See you later. Have fun with your lives, and hope keto's for you.